Tracking and maintaining good habits is one of the best ways to make lasting change in a positive direction. Notion is one of the best tools for this because of its all-in-one customizable features. In this video, we wanted to show you step-by-step how to build a habit tracker from scratch. Stay until the end to download our free standard habit tracker Notion template, which includes additional habit goals and reflection pages. If you find this helpful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. Let's first start with an empty Notion page to get started with this habit tracker. So let's go ahead and title the page Habit Tracker Template. And we can go ahead and add a cover photo if you wish by clicking Add Cover, Change Cover, and you can look for things in Unsplash. For example, some kind of notebook could fit this theme very well. And next you can add an icon if you wish by clicking Add Icon, and we'll go ahead and use something with check marks like this. And the first thing we always like to do when we start a new Notion page and dashboard is to go to the top right hand corner three dots and turn on small text full width. And this allows us to have more space on the page. For this habit tracker, we're going to be having two separate columns. So we're going to go ahead and type slash column and create two columns. And this side is going to have a mood picture. So we're going to type slash image and add an image. And let's go ahead and go to Unsplash. Of course, you can add your own images as well by uploading it. And in Unsplash, we can go ahead and look for a motivational quote, such as this one. And then we can reposition it a bit so that it's more on the left-hand side. And on this side, we can create our rewards and goals. So when habit tracking, it's really important to have a space for goal setting and reward setting. So we're going to go ahead and type slash heading 3 and call this one rewards and goals, and then slash divider to add a divider underneath. And what we're going to add here for rewards and goals is basically a gallery view database. We're going to type slash gallery view to create an inline database plus new gallery. And here it's going to be our rewards and goals. And we can go ahead and click the three dots here to hide the database title, so it's a little bit cleaner here. And we can also click here and rename it to, for example, view. So the first thing we can do is just create a very simple database template so that each of these rewards and goals are going to show up the same way. So if we go ahead and click this blue button here and click plus new template, we can start crafting our database templates. So let's go ahead and call this new reward and goal. Then what we're going to do is remove the created time and delete property. We're also going to remove tags by clicking here and delete property as well. And then what we're going to be adding is a text property by searching for text, and we're going to call this note to self. So this is a great place to add motivational messages as you go forward with your habit tracking. Inside of this reward and goal section, we're going to be typing your rewards and goals. And let's go ahead and click the six dots on the left-hand side and color it so that the background is a gray color. And we can also bold this. And now what we can do is add checkboxes. So we can type slash checkbox, and we can list our goal 1 and reward 1. So how this would work is when you accomplish goal 1, you would give yourself reward 1. So let's do the same here. Goal 2, reward 2, goal 3, reward 3, and goal 4, reward 4. So obviously, if you don't need all of these rewards, you can pare it down to however many you feel like you want to do per week. And once you have that set up, we can go ahead and click out. So now what happens is if we just delete all of these three things inside of our gallery view, you can highlight them all and then click delete. And then you can go ahead and set up this database template to be the default. So now if we click plus new, we are going to get a new database page with this template. And the first one is going to be your first week rewards. And what we can do is add an icon by clicking add icon. And we can go ahead and find these circles. So if there's 4 weeks in a month, and we highly recommend you to do habit tracking in kind of monthly cycles. So this kind of circle could make a lot of sense for this, so we can do this and then click out. And let's go ahead and show the note to self. So let's put something like, you've got this. And if we go to the three dots here, go to properties, and we can show this one. So now we can see sort of inside of your page as well as your note to self. So let's go ahead and add another one. So this one would be second week rewards, and you can add an icon for the next circle. So it would be the one that's half. You can do the others as well. So basically just fill them all in. So now we have each of the week's rewards here so that you can see your rewards and goals for the monthly habit tracking. The next thing we're going to be adding is the main habit tracker. So if we go and hover over here, you'll notice there's a plus sign, and you can click that to add a new block underneath your rewards and goals. And here we're going to type /heading 3, and this one is going to be your main habit tracker. Let's go ahead and call this habit calendar and data, and then we're going to type /divider. And inside here, what we're going to do is first add a calendar. So we're going to type /calendar and add a calendar view inline database. And we're going to call this habit calendar. You can click the three dots here, hide database title, so it looks a bit cleaner. And now what we need to do is add the correct properties to each of your data entries. So first, let's start by just clicking open, add an item to see what's available. So basically, every time you have a new habit entry, you would want to make sure that you have a space to check off your habits. So let's just call this new entry. And inside here, we can remove this one, the tags, by clicking delete property. And obviously date is important as this is a calendar-based database. And what would be nice is if we know the day of the week. So we can go ahead and click plus add a property. And let's go ahead and add a formula property that's going to show us the day of the week. So if we go ahead and edit this, you can add something like this where it's format date, and then it's going to convert it to the name of the day of the week. Then we're going to click done. So now you can see it says Wednesday. So let's go ahead and also rename this day of the week like this. The next thing we're going to do is add the three habits. So we're going to click plus add a property, and let's go ahead and find a checkbox here, and then we can call this habit 1. So obviously this is going to be the part where you're going to want to actually customize it. So you can basically name this whatever habit you want to work on. We recommend about 3 habits per month, but of course you can add more or less than that. So let's go ahead and duplicate this one by clicking duplicate property, and we can click and duplicate one more time. And we can also rename this to habit 2 and rename this one to habit 3. So now you have the option to actually check off each of your habits every day. And finally, what's really nice is if you can calculate how many out of the total number of habits have you checked off every day. So for that, you can add another formula. So we're going to click plus add a property formula. So let's go ahead and call this count, and we can edit it. And we recommend something like this. So basically, it's formatting this into a text. So if habit 1 is true, then it's going to return 1. If habit 3 is true, it's going to return 1. If habit 2 is true, it's going to return 1. And if it's not true, it's going to return 0. So that way you can add up the number of habits that are checked at the moment and then count them out of 3. So if we go ahead and click done, and let's say that we check this one off like this, it's going to update the count. And the cool thing is that you can also jot down notes inside of your habit entries in case you also want journaling as part of the process. And if we click out, now what we can do is figure out how to show this data. So if we go to the three dots over here and go to properties, we can now turn on the relevant properties. So obviously you want to be able to check off habit 1, habit 2, and habit 3. It's nice to know the day of the week and also the count. So we can move the day of the week up here like this, and you can see your habits like this. So when you click them, you can also click them through here, and it's very useful. The next thing we're going to do is add a monthly tracking system. So if we go ahead and click the plus sign here, we can actually add now a table view of this database and click done. So now we can move around the day of the week here, and let's say the count at the end of the habits. You can go ahead and click here and also freeze up the column so you can actually scroll better. And let's go ahead and also hide the database title here as well. And what's going to be great is if we can actually group this by month. So we're going to rename this monthly report. And basically you can go to the three dots here and go to group, and then we're going to group it by date and date by month. And we want the newest to the top so that we can easily see it. So now we basically have June 2024. And what you can also do is actually count the numbers for each of your habits over the month. So for here, let's say that we're going to do the count for the checked. You can do something like this and turn those on so you can actually sort of tally up how many you've actually done each month. And you can also calculate how many actual entries you have here as well. So you can also do something like count all. And then after that, we can actually create individual tabs for each of your habits. So let's go ahead and click plus here. And we're again going to choose table view, done. And let's call this one habit one. And we can go ahead and hide the database title. And basically what we can do is just to only show habit one's stats. So if we go ahead and hide this in view and hide this one in view and hide this one in view, you can only see habit one. And let's also go ahead and hide this one so that we show very minimal information so that it's very clear. So now we basically have the name, the date, and the habit. And what we can do is calculate here the count checked as well. And we can also group this by, for example, week. So if we go to date, and then we can group by week and see sort of weekly statistics about each of your habits. So let's go ahead and duplicate this one, call this one habit two, and we can duplicate it again and call this one habit three. And one thing we need to do is just make sure that the groupings make sense. If we go to group, and we want to show the newest first, so we see those at the top. So make sure to check for that. So once you have that set up, let's go ahead and fix this up a bit. So we're going to go ahead and hide this one in view, but turn on the habit two. We're going to do the same for habit three. You can go to the three dots, go to properties, and then turn on habit three, but turn off habit one. And we can also add the count so that we see what's checked. So now we basically have a calendar view, monthly reports, habit one, habit two, and habit three, as well as your rewards and goals. Another thing you can add is a simple callout box by typing slash callout. And inside here, if we click the six dots, we can color it to default background. And what you can add here is a habit setting and reflection. So let's go ahead and call this habit settings and reflection. And we can go ahead and turn this bold, change the icon to something more like a line. And inside here, if you type shift enter, you can type slash page and add various pages in here for example, habit setting. And you can type all sorts of things inside of here to actually think about it. You can then also move this under here and click plus slash page and reflection. So in this way, you can really create your custom habit settings and reflection pages. And if you download our free habit tracker Notion template, it also includes dedicated habit settings and reflections if you're looking for some inspiration on what kind of questions you might want to answer. The last thing we wanted to show you really quickly is that if you want this to just duplicate every day on this calendar, you can actually set that up by going to the blue button here and creating a new database template. So this is a new habit entry, and the date is going to be the date when it's duplicated. And if we go back, then what's going to happen is if you go here and then go to set as default, it's going to set for all views in calendar. And then you can also go again to the three dots here, set the repeat to daily, and then select the correct time that you want it to start repeating at. So this way you don't really have to think too much. You just have it there every day, and then you can choose to select them and make sure to tick off your habits. Thank you so much for watching. The link to the free habit tracker is in the description below. Feel free to let us know if you have any questions or comments, and we hope to see you all in the next video.